Hello everyone, I'm Seni Mahadhanan from the Department of Earth Resources Engineering. Today I would like to present my final year research project on topic of investigation of coal and other industrial metal recovery potentials in waste industrial reports and hydrometallurgical approach to extract gold using a less toxic method. So, throughout this presentation, I'm going to talk about these topics. First, I would like to give some background information on this study. So, I think you all have learned the word e-waste. E-waste is waste electrical and electronic equipment that have been discarded by the user without any intention of reusing. Simply, e-waste can be categorized into six classes and they are listed in here. Then, we'll move on to the general composition of e-waste. As you can see, e-waste mainly consists of metals and plastics. Composition of metals is exceeding 60%. The significant electronic component in e-waste is printed circuit board. PCBs support to connect other electronic components through their conductive tracks. In PCBs, 70% of weight is metals. So, PCBs are considered as good sources for metals such as copper, nickel, lead, zinc, and gold. So, gold. Gold is a transition metal element having atomic number of 79. Naturally, gold occurs in its native form with the association of silver and copper. Gold has some unique properties such as highest malleability and ductility among all metals, high thermal and electrical conductivity, stability and corrosion resistivity. So, these properties have turned gold into the highly desired metal all over the human history. The primary use of gold is jewelry and ornament manufacturing. And due to the high value and rarity, gold is used in investment field as gold bars or coins. Electronic industry, the third largest consumer of gold. According to the World Gold Council, only 55,000 tons are remaining as ore reserves out of 190,000 of tons. China, Australia, and Russia supply more than 65% of world gold production. However, 25% of gold supply is done by recycling of gold products such as jewelry recycling. As you can see, the gold production has been decreased by 6.5% in major gold mining companies due to the limitations in natural ores and the instability of world economy. Therefore, the deficiency of gold due to these reasons have become a major issue. According to the World Gold Council, the spot price of gold have a significant increasing trend in the last 2 decades. That is due to the 4th and 5th industrial revolutions. Therefore, there is a high market opportunity for gold with increasing of gold price. As you can see, there is a continuous increment in e-waste generation and per capita e-waste generation. Since gold is a major metal used in the electronic industry, there may be a potential to recover those gold from e-waste. So, the potential of e-waste as an alternative source of gold should be investigated. Also, most developing countries, such as Sri Lanka, have no economically viable gold deposits. Therefore, seeking out secondary resources will be a strategic move to face upcoming technological revolutions. Since PCBs use gold as a thin film in contacts, solder joints, and connecting wires, the gold content should be higher in PCB components, such as connecting wires within IC chips, contact points in microprocessors, plated metric pins, and contact planes in computer cards. Likewise. So, it is predicted that gold content in e-waste is higher than the concentration of gold in most of natural ore. Therefore, many research have developed gold extraction methods for e-waste. So, in this table, show several hydrometallurgical approaches gold extraction from e-waste. In here, acid leaching, cyanide leaching, and halite leaching are either corrosive or toxic method. And the bioleaching is a very much eco-friendly method, but it is an extremely slow process. So the urea leaching and thiosulfate leaching are the best alternative for gold leaching any waste. So as a method with the high selectivity and non-toxic, non-corrosive method, thiosulfate leaching was selected to study in this project. So the aim of the project is to develop an effective procedure to leach gold with high yield and purity from waste-free circuit board residue using relatively low toxic reagents and chemicals. And throughout this project, the secondary objectives were tried to achieve. Then we'll move on to the research workflow and results. So after the conceptual study, sample preparation was done using several pre-processing stages. Then the initial concentrations of metals were determined using a digestion process, and for gold leaching, ammonium thiosulfate was used as a less toxic reagent. Then the samples were analyzed using the ICP-MA, and then the proposed leaching technique was analyzed based on the leaching efficiencies. In sample preparation stage, first discarded motherboard samples were collected, and then ECP components were separated manually. And thirdly, samples were classified into three classes, which are microprocessors and IC components, plated connectors and network card, plated metallic pins. After that, the manual crushing and grinding in thermomill were done. Finally, ground samples were sieved and obtained the size fractions for each sample classes. However, we were unable to achieve minus 63 micrometer plated metallic pin sample because of the high malleability of gold. The aqua-regia digestion was done using 3 to 1 ratio of HNO3 and HCl acids at 200 degrees Celsius for 2 hours. Aqua-regia dissolves gold and almost all other metals. So these were the results obtained from the ICP-MS analysis. As a summary, the gold concentration is significantly high in almost every sample. The highest concentration was recorded in plated metallic pin sample. So we can conclude that there is an enormous recovery potential for gold in base printed circuit board. And also, the metallic content of the base metals, such as copper and nickel, are significantly higher than the any other metal, especially copper containing metallic pin sample was 480 ppm level. Therefore, the recovery potential of base metals are also high. For other industrial metals, high cadmium and arsenic content have occurred due to the usage of semiconductors in microprocessors, and high lead containing metallic pin samples have recorded due to the use of metal alloys. Then the gold leaching was done using ammonium thiosulfate mixture. The final mixture consists of 1 m sodium thiosulfate, 0.5 m ammonium hydroxide, 0.25 m ammonium sulfate, and 10 mm copper sulfate. In here, ammonium hydroxide was used to stabilize the thiosulfate complex, and the copper sulfate was used as a catalyst. So we have to limit these leaching parameters into these values due to the time limitation and laboratory facility elimination due to the COVID-19 pandemic. After the ICP-MS analysis, leaching efficiencies were calculated and all the efficiencies were below 1% level. So we can conclude that the leaching parameters we followed might not be suitable for this technique. So here I have done some comparison between available literature with our process. So comparatively, leaching time should be the critical parameter for obtaining such a low level leaching efficiency. In summary, gold is one of highly demanded precious metal, and it is one of the major metal in electronic industry, and gold mining is failing to meet the existing demand. Therefore, secondary sources to gold is needed. And PCBs have 70% of weight as metals, and they are good alternative sources for gold. And the available gold extraction techniques are highly corrosive or highly toxic. Therefore, investigation of eco-friendly techniques for gold extraction is needed. So, this study confirmed the recovery potential of gold and other industrially valuable metals in waste PCB components. So, according to the results, both gold and copper content are higher in plated metallic pins, and leaching of gold done using ammonium thiosulfate in the presence of copper 2 plus ions, and the followed methodology consists of sample pre-processing, leaching, and sample analysis using ICP-MS. And this project will be a preliminary study to develop an environment-friendly process for recovering gold from waste-treated steel boards. Finally, let me give some recommendations based on this study. So, the main recommendation is to investigate all these leaching parameters and solution concentration, which means effect of leaching time, the rate and availability of oxygen, bulk density, copper sulfate, sodium thiosulfate, and ammonium concentration with respect to the gold leaching from e-waste. Because we were unable to do this investigation due to the pandemic situation. Also, we recommend to identify the optimum size reduction process by assessing different comminution techniques. And also, we recommend to evaluate the economic and ecotoxicity of copper and nickel selective extraction processes, because the recovery potential of these two metals, copper and nickel, were exceptional. Finally, these are the references we mainly use for this presentation, and this is the end of my presentation. So, thank you very much for listening. Thank you.